The casket containing the remains of the late prominent businessman Apollo Nyegamehe, commonly known as Aponyi, was wheeled in at his home in Lubowa, Machinje Division, today afternoon from the funeral home where it has been kept for the past 2 days. Scores of mourners who had already gathered at home for the official vigil started with viewing of the body. During Mass, Father Benedict Mubangizi cautioned mourners against greediness of earthly things. He encouraged mourners to live a spiritual life and prepare for their death.
If God was to come now, if Jesus was to come as an unexpected visitor, is Jesus having a seat in your heart? Is there any sofa set in your heart? We are minding much on these worldly things. Apollo had many things. They are putting them on social media. Many things. What now? Is there anything that saved him or took him to the hospital?
Members of the business community noted that the death of Aponyi is a big blow to the business people and the country at large. They remembered the late as a mentor in the business community.
Confirm that on your behalf, everybody here, the business community, to do whatever it takes for Apollo to have a befitting send-off. No money should come from his business. Whatever expenses required will be contributed by us and you people present. Thank you very much.
They asked the family members and the late's children to keep the deceased legacy, but most importantly, ensure that his businesses flourish even in his death.
Good people pass very fast. They pass away very fast. It's because God knows them. They have an assignment on earth to do. But what I want to say to the family of my late brother Aponyi, continue with the same prayers. That name should be there. Expand the business as he used to do, and God will continue to bless you.
A requiem mass for the deceased will be held in Luraga Cathedral tomorrow. Thereafter, the deceased will be taken to his final resting home in Ruchiga District, and burial will take place on Wednesday. Aponyi died in a tragic accident on Thursday evening after his car rammed into a stationary truck at Itojo, Ntungamo District, killing him instantly and leaving two of the car occupants, that included the driver and his brother, injured. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.